I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight. The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel a presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop...
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Colored clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night, and just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper, go to sleep, everything.
Previously on Alan Wake, I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
Behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
Weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up. Hey, handsome. This is gonna be a long night, but these shots are turning out great.
I guess you're gonna need that coffee then. I'll go put it on. Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
These look really good.
sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan, please check the fuse box!
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please, hurry!
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, Ryder boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wick, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now. Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake?
How did you end up at Stuckey's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called
Lover's Peak. Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Hey!
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there.
I couldn't go anywhere yet. I had to play along with the caller. Alice's life was at stake.
They don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left. Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The collar meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor carves a statue.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never...
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice.
I had to talk to someone.
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. Takes a Swing at Everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl, and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you
Wait
shot
here.
A guy, and his body
Easy
just
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You're on Cabots.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap.
When was the last time
They're
you
illegal
slept?
To use here.
Well, are you Hell, high? Have you been drinking? No!
Look, Barry,
I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do
and everything's just...
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong. It's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm. Seriously, Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper.
Wait
Those
here.
Situations always end up in disaster.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the path and you'll get to it eventually.
To the cops.
It's an easy walk.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
That's just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her!
This is not a goddamn debate.
Hurt you!
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Archie!
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Locking the door now.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Hey,
vision left me weak. This was no head injury.
No!
Rusty, hang on! I'm coming!
Please, help me!
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened. The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. It was too late. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Rusty! Rusty!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Fishing!
Yes,
open. For those
prisoners
who purchase a park...
Fishing.
License! Obey!
The Margrave's instructions.
Rusty, no! Never! Any other
wildfire clip closer than 25 yards.
Pets must be leashed.
At all times.
Never leave your
pet unattended.
It is
against the law
to remove any
natural objects
or historical artifacts from the park.
Sir.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it. Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail,